Good afternoon. My name is Ann Carpenter. I'm a teacher at the Stockloso Middle School in Lowell. I was interested in going on this trip to Cambodia with the Fulbright Hayes Group because I served as a Peace Corps volunteer for over 2 years in Mali in West Africa. And I had a very strong connection and understanding with my African students. And I was hoping to establish a similarly strong connection based on understanding about the culture with my Cambodian students. I teach seventh grade science, and the trip was mostly focused on art, but I always say if I were not a science teacher, I'd be an art teacher because I have a strong appreciation for the arts. I began the year with an environmental science unit, and we have an entirely new curriculum this year, so I had to figure out how it would fit into what we were doing this year. And I began the year with some videos and with a visit to the school by Kalyan Imam, who is a filmmaker on environmental issues from Cambodia. So I'll talk a little bit more about that later. My title is Balancing the Economy, Culture, and the Environment. And this garbage receptacle, which we saw in the city of Battambang, symbolizes what I see as Cambodia's approach to modernizing and having a better future by balancing the economy, culture, and the environment. I found all of Cambodia's problems are problems that are world problems, but we have them to different degrees and in different places. We certainly have solid waste disposal issues in this country, and particularly plastics, and they have plastics disposal problems in Cambodia. We have water supply issues and sanitation, which I think we were a little surprised to find out that we have lead and copper issues in schools. Cambodia also has water supply and sanitation issues, probably to a more serious degree. And we all, both countries and the rest of the world, have issues between rural and urban inequities and a movement to urban areas. In Cambodia, we observe many people exiting the factory at the end of the day, being trucked back to different parts of the city. And these are people who come from many different parts of Cambodia. They don't really have a choice except to move to the cities if they want to be successful economically, or I wouldn't even say successful, if they want to hang on, if they want to be able to feed their families. Here is another problem, is threats to natural resources. Everywhere we went, we saw wood being cut down and huge, massive carvings made out of wood. I find this particularly ironic because it's an endangered species carving made from probably endangered wood. So it's wonderful, but at the same time it's very sad because it's because of the destruction that's happening. No place where the problems were evident than on the Tonle Sap, between the inequities, problems with water quality, problems with health. And one of the films that I showed earlier in the year to begin the year with my students were produced by Conservation International, and it's about their approach towards improving economic stability of families on the Tonle Sap, stabilizing the fisheries, improving water quality so that people can live happier and healthier lives. So a theme that's run through my curriculum this year is that you have to balance the economy and the environment, and that you can, that there's a cost to environmental degradation that we need to look at. And I think this was particularly apparent on the Tonle Sap. And Cambodia has its own approach to solving their economic and environmental problems. Many of them involve organizations that produce arts, that train people to do jobs in productive careers like restaurants. We visited many sites where traditional crafts are being used to train people to have jobs so that they can improve their situation economically without having to leave their villages. This was a great example. This solves so many problems. It's an efficient cooking stove. It's made from recycled materials and mud that's found locally. It's produced by local people, and it will reduce the amount of wood that people have to use to cook their dinners. So they can use less wood and make cut down fewer forests and produce less pollution by using these, and these are created locally. I particularly enjoyed the day we met the governor of Baden-Baden, because he is taking on many of these issues. I really felt a connection with him. This symbolizes what I see as a really great solution. It solves environmental problems and economic problems, and it also helps preserve culture. The shape is a traditional cooking pot. It's made from recycled tires, and the purpose is to clean up garbage that's often found on city streets, which would discourage tourism. So, in summary, it's a solution. This is an exceptional solution to a problem. It results in a cleaner city, which boosts tourism, which improves the economy. It uses a traditional form for a trash receptacle, and it's made from recycled materials. We also visited a site in Siem Reap where textiles are being produced, and they've created an innovative water treatment plant to clean up effluent, which might be toxic from the textile production facility. At the American University of Phnom Penh, I met with two young ladies who were studying water quality in a drainage area in a heavily developed area, and they actually recently had a training program for people that live in the community to understand why they should clean up and how to clean up and protect the water drainage area in their community. At the Cambridge Cambodia School, which is a sister school to my school, I was very interested in the water supply and how it's treated, and the system that they're using is a standard. It looks like a good system. One of the projects I want to do in the future is to make sure that the water quality is adequate, that they are in fact changing the charcoal or the sand, or getting water that's up to standard. There was a little pond which was lovely, but probably is somewhat polluted. And as a result, so one of the other things I want to do, and this is another shared problem between my school and the Cambridge Cambodia School. Children bring water bottles to school every day now, which is great because they didn't used to do that, so that at least they're drinking water every day. But every day at my school, they're leaving the bottles behind. They don't have names on them. At the end of the day, I go around, I collect the water, dump the water, and put the bottles in recycling. We're producing a huge amount of waste for my school just from bottles. I found out that the same thing is happening at the Cambridge Cambodia School. Children carry purchased water. Neither of these groups of children can afford to go out and buy water, or shouldn't have to. So one of the things I would like to look into is purchasing some kind of reusable water bottle that can be personalized, so that when they get left behind, we can return them to the person they belong to, they can wash them up, and they can get reused, so we're not producing as much garbage. If we can turn it into a fundraiser, we would be able to turn the money back over to perhaps the garden at Cambridge Cambodia School, or perhaps finding a way to get reusable water bottles over there. This was the day that Kalyani Mom came to visit my school. She established a wonderful connection with the children. She shared her experience as a refugee and an immigrant, and she asked the students who were immigrants and who were refugees. And in my school, I think it was probably about half the kids. And it was a group of seventh graders. They were enthralled by her. They were totally focused. And many, many students raised their hand because they wanted to share their experience as refugees from Syria, from Iraq, from Africa, and also from Cambodia, from Myanmar. It was really a wonderful day. She showed a video, and they learned more about deforestation and issues of environmental protection in Cambodia. On another occasion, we were visited by Ambassador William Height, and he also established a wonderful connection with the children, and they learned a lot more. Finally, here we are, here are the students in the garden with Kali and Imam, and as you can see, it's the United Nations of Stockholm, so there are children from Africa, Asia, Middle East, Caribbean, Latin America. So in summary, I just want to say I think the garbage receptacle is a great example of where Cambodia is going in balancing the economy, the environment, and preserving their culture. Thank you.